Deepwater Horizon oil spill occurred, and that was about 5,000 feet deep. Everyone wanted to know, well, what animals live at those depths? What animals are going to be directly affected by that oil? And for the most part, we had to say we don't know. So that's what drove us to start a lot of this work. That's the biggest species of gopher. It's a big one. Well, you think of a gopher as a mid to lower slope animal, a pretty deep animal, you know. See the big green eyes. This animal lives at twilight level, so it's got big green eyes.
They're an adaptation for the shark to see distantly through the dark, murky water of the deep ocean. Gulpers swim in really deep parts of the ocean, like 5,000 feet down, and they're abundant in the DeSoto Canyon.
There are at least six species of gulper sharks in the Gulf of Mexico, ranging in size from 1 to 6 feet long. Gulpers are great hunters, known to feed on smaller fish and cephalopods like squid.
Check my shark eye camera.
In La Jolla, California, near the Scripps Canyon, marine biologist Dr. David Gruber prepares to have a close encounter with an alien shark that also glows in the deep. Gruber's quest grew from an amazing discovery that he made by accident.
This started out in making an exhibit for a museum. And we get back at night, and we're looking at the photos, and in one of these photos is a glowing fish. These fluorescent molecules that we're finding in the ocean have applications in medical research. A fluorescent protein originally found from a biofluorescent jellyfish led to countless scientific discoveries, AIDS, Alzheimer, cancer research. It's probably one of the most versatile and widely used tools in medical science today.
Two of the hundreds of species Gruber discovered were sharks, including a rare and odd glowing green swell shark. He's on a quest to understand what purpose their neon glow has. To do this, he needs to witness the undersea world as the swell shark does. In Hualin, Taiwan, shark researcher Paul Clerken and his mentor, Dr. Dave Ebert, are on a quest to make scientific history.
It's thought to be very, very rare, but we have reason to believe that they're actually just very elusive, and we found a captain who tells us he can definitely find us a megamouth.
Only 5% of all the world's oceans have been explored, and very little is known about these mysterious seas or about the creatures that inhabit them. Armed with better technologies and equipment, marine scientists are venturing deeper into the sea than ever before.
People don't realize it, but we're actually living in the renaissance of shark exploration. In the last 10 years, nearly 200 new shark species have been discovered.
And scientists believe there are still untold numbers of sharks yet to be found, thousands of feet below the surface.